will not have to be in disarray or more strain. Jesus, the Good Shepherd, He has called us into a place where we can find rest and peace. And on this beautiful Sunday communion morning, find rest in Him. Find peace in Him. For He is faithful, He is holy, and He is worthy. We bow in Your presence, oh Father. We say thank You and we give You the glory. We worship and adore You. Even as You come on the line, we say the Lord bless You. And we give God glory and honor. We exalt His holy name. We lift our hands and we say, Abba. All praises unto Your name. All praises unto Your name. For You are unstoppable. You are all powerful. You are the unstoppable God, and we bless Your holy name. We say thank You, holy, holy. You are Lord God Almighty. We thank You that the earth is filled with Your glory. We thank You, Almighty God, for greater is He that is in us than he that is in the world, God. We say thank You, our Abba Father, for You are amazing, You are marvelous, and You are wonderful. And Father, we bless You. We say thank You, Lord, and we give You glory, and we give You honor. We bless Your holy name. Worthy, worthy is the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. This morning, a shift, we're going to go straight into our communion service. For those of you that are ready and at home and you have your communion, we're going to have it this morning. Hallelujah. Father, we say thank You. Today, the gap is bridged between God and man through Jesus Christ, our mediator. And we say thank you for the finished work on the cross.
Hallelujah.
We lift the wafer before you. This morning, we bless it and we sanctify it. As we partake, may we remember our calling. May we remember we are called to be witnesses. May we remember, mighty God, that we are healed, we are delivered, and set free. As we partake, knowing that there is nothing that is too difficult for you. So, Father, we say thank you. We bless and we sanctify in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Let us partake of the wafer. We bless you. Father, we lift the wine and we say thank you, Almighty God. As we lift the wine which represents the righteous, precious blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we say, holy, holy, holy. And we declare that your people, Father, as the blood has given us the victory, that your people, as they partake, they will remember they are victorious through the blood of Jesus Christ. They will remember that you won the victory as you walked up Golgotha's hill, and even as you was nailed to the cross for us. We thank you, Lord, for being nailed to the cross. Hallelujah. It is so time. In the name of Jesus, we declare this wine blessed and it is sanctified. And as you partake the victory for our powerful service, a powerful month of October, our Father, a miraculous and a magnificent month, Lord, to bask in your glory and to be drawn closer to you. Almighty God, we say thank you as we partake in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Jesus, fire. Jesus, you deserve the praise. What is your name? Yeah.
Saviour set free. When we look back and see what the Lord has done for us through the finished work on the cross, we do not have enough time.
Hallelujah.
It's all about Him. When I reflect on my Savior, I can personalize it because I know what He means to me.
Yes, Lord.
I know what He has done for me.
Yes, Lord.
I can never walk
backwards. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Into the year 2020, into the month of October, and you. incomplete. I just want to run. When I say run, I mean run. You don't know where you're going, but you're ready to run. Stand to that side. There are many accounts where people got themselves in different situations. And there was an account in the Bible, who can tell me? the race of the young man's life. It was a race of the young man's life. Anybody can tell me the Bible? A race for a little boy's life. His mother looked not as if at his impending death. But she was able to saddle the donkey and go to the man of God. Amen. Amen. You all remember that?
Yes.
She couldn't conceive, she couldn't have children, but a word came forth. She had a child. Now, it looks like the child is about to die. But she did not accept it.
Amen.
She did not accept the impending death. Today, don't accept contrary situation. Know who your God is and know how he works. As you hold fast, that woman, she is seeing a dead son, but she held on to great faith.
Amen.
Amen. We talk faith, but when we are thrown in the furnace, do we show faith?
Amen.
Amen. Because you're going to be thrown in the fiery furnace.
Hallelujah.
Meaning that your trials are going to be hot.
Amen.
Are you going to say, God, I'm going to give up, or you're going to fight the good fight of faith?
Fight.
Amen. When the fiery testings and trials come, fight. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And who remember the choir that won the battle by singing praises unto God?
Amen.
Let me ask the choir, the worshipers. Who remember? Nobody? The Levites? I'm listening. She said the Levites, one said the Levites. You all, I preached at you. I still remember me preaching that. The choir that won the battle by singing praises to Jehovah God. Remember Jehoshaphat had a battle. And he had to call the singers, the worshippers, to lead in the battle. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He had to call the worshippers to lead in the battle. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And as the worshippers lead, we all know that they that will preach and minister will be of the tribe of Levi.
Amen.
So the thing about it, as they began to sing, the enemy got confused. Your worship is going to confuse the enemy. Amen. That is why it is so important that we worship the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. We pause and we take time out to give God proper worship. Amen.
Amen.
When we stop to give God what is due unto him, God will stop and release that which belongs to you and is still in the heavens.
Amen.
Amen. All of us that are seated here and on the line, God has something in store for us. But we must tap into the realm of the Spirit to receive it.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And who was the young man that will not bend, budge, or burn? Huh? Who was the young man? Or the young man? Yeah? Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, the three young men. If I say three, it's too easy. Of course I say the young men.
Amen.
When you are put in the fiery testing, will you bow? Will you budge to the enemy? Or will you refuse and receive a victory?
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You gotta refuse anything that the devil wanna give you.
Amen.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Father. Well, it's a house. Because he can give you material possession.
Yes.
But there's a price.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Your soul that's supposed to rest in eternity with Jesus will rest in eternity with Satan and will not even find rest. Will be in torment. Let me say it correct. So these are things that we have to look at. We say church and we say we love God, but when the testing comes, what is our character like? Are we pressing through faith?
Amen.
We need to know who our God is. And remember, there were 9 men that forget to say thank you.
Yes.
9 men forgetting to say thank you.
Yes.
You got the miracle.
Yes.
And you forget to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
But God is big on thanks because he said, where are the other 9?
Yes.
Where are the others who were healed? He sent them to go show themselves to the priests so that they will be made clean. Well, to go back out into society. But only one came back. And the Lord blessed him, but one that came back. They were clean, all 10. They were made clean. But the one that came back, they said, thank you, receive a personal blessing from the master himself, beyond the healing man. Hallelujah. You got to know when you come back to God, to say thank you, you receive beyond your healing. Amen.
Amen.
That touch of Jesus is beautiful. We want to look into the book of 1 Samuel. We thank God again for everyone. We just want to bless the Lord. The book of 1 Samuel, chapter 3. Hallelujah. Thank God for all of you that, you know, you go down for a little bit for whatever flu or other ailments or challenges, but you're in the house today. We rejoice with you in the name of Jesus, as you are able to come and celebrate Jesus with us. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory, glory. Glory to his name. Amen.
Amen.
What a wonderful, wonderful Savior who died on the cross. Many a times, God will speak directly and audibly to people in the time of Joshua, in the time of Moses, even in the time of Abraham, they were heard the Lord, his voice. And in the time of the judges, it was difficult. It wasn't so prevalent to hear the voice of the Lord. But there was a young man who God allowed to hear his voice.
Amen. Amen.
God is looking for men and women, and young men and young women, to hear his voice.
Amen. Amen.
Samuel was a mighty man.
Amen.
But listen well. He was given to God from an early age, and he practiced until the very end.
Amen.
The word of God that was taught him to him, he carried it through his lifestyle. He had a weakness where concerning his sons, they did not do it right.
Yeah. Amen.
And sons and daughters like to do their own things sometimes.
Amen.
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 But Samuel, when you check his history, God had nothing bad to say about Samuel.
Amen. Amen.
But his sons is a different thing when you read the word.
Yeah.
It is clearly stated they did not honor God. So not because your parents are saved, it means that you will get an honorable report.
Amen. Amen.
Each person must live a set apart life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
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 And Samuel was dedicated to the Lord. His mother made a promise to the Lord, Hannah, if she would conceive, she would bring the baby back to God, offer that baby, and allow that baby to serve God from the temple.
Yes.
She kept her promise.
Amen.
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 I do not know what you have promised God, but did you keep it?
Hallelujah.
Are you keeping your promises to God?
Amen.
When we accepted Jesus on that day, some of us would have said, Lord, I'm going with you.
Hallelujah.
And you have not been consistent in your going.
Amen.
How many of you love when the internet is sticking? You enjoy the internet when it's sticking and you can't see the light. And it's just sticking and you get an interference. How many of you enjoy that? Let me see how many. Nobody. Why? Because you can't get the fullness of what is taking place on the other side.
Amen.
When you want the fullness of heaven, you can't be sticking in your walk with God. Amen.
Amen.
You got to understand there must be clear communication lines.
Amen.
Yeah?
Amen.
God is true to his word.
Yes.
And he keeps all of his promises.
Hallelujah.
And for the child of God, Wi-Fi would not work in the realm of the spirit. You've got to hook up with your own data. Meaning your own personal relationship with God. Amen.
Amen.
The intercessors and them, they are the Wi-Fi connection. So you have a connection there with the intercessors through the Wi-Fi in the realm of the spirit. But when you really want God, you've got to have your own data plan.
Amen.
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 Amen. Your personal data. So you will have a personal relationship with him.
Amen.
Amen. Because when the intercessor decides to change their password and not pray you through, you are in trouble. You are in trouble.
Amen.
You must have your own prayer line.
Amen.
Amen. How many people have their own prayer line?
Amen.
Hallelujah. You gotta have a prayer line. When you look at the devastation with Hurricane Ian, how many people have died so far now? I didn't see them yesterday. Nobody looks at the news. So we are all in a great place, so we don't look and listen to the news. So you're not seeing how many people dying. And they are rescuing people with helicopters. Their houses are flooded out. Their fridge, refrigerators, their stove is just washing out of their house. It's just coming down in the water. Nobody saw the news? Let me see. How many people... I think the last time I was, you said it was around 42 or something like that. I'm not sure how much now. It's more, but they said the numbers were rising. They said it's a flood. It's a flood and it's a hurricane like never before that hit Florida.
Amen.
We had something that was coming to us. So don't take it for granted when God gives us favor.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Be grateful. I look at people crying. They are crying. They lost everything. Their cars are just going. They are watching the latest cars just go down. It's covered. It's just going down. I am here to tell you today, Jesus is coming.
Amen.
And the times are different. You don't have the time to play with sin. Amen.
Amen.
To the young people and to the adults, to the teenagers, sin can never set you free. It will always hold you bound.
Amen.
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 Sin can never, ever have you free. You know, people say, I want my freedom, and they have freedom to go and sin. It can never set you free.
Amen.
You are slave to sin.
Amen. Amen.
The church needs to come to a place where we don't hide and watch pornography.
Amen.
Not we, but you all.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And do the follow-up of what it makes people do. Sin. Further.
Amen.
Unholiness. Amen.
Amen.
I'm saying all of that to say, children of the Most High God, get real with God.
Amen.
Men, women, and children, do it right. This man didn't have no time to play. He was a young boy.
Yes.
But you know what? He was focused.
Amen.
He loved God. And he was willing to do it God's way. Amen.
Amen.
Bible says, and the child Samuel ministered unto the Lord before Eli. And the word of the Lord was precious in those days. There was no open vision. I remember I was telling you also at that time, in time of the judges, that the voice of the Lord was a rare and precious thing.
Yeah,
how many of you will be excited to hear from God and audible voice?
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. And this time and in this season, Bible is saying here what's happening. And it came to pass at that time when Eli was laid down in his place and his eye began to wax dim, that he could not see. And here the lamp of God went out in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was, and Samuel was laid down to sleep. So we see here that even at that time, what was happening with Eli the priest.
Yeah.
And the Lord called Samuel, and he answered, "Here am I." I want you to look at verse 4. And the Lord called Samuel. What's the next part? God is calling you today.
Amen.
Where are you? Are you like Adam in the garden hiding? Or are you like Samuel saying, "Here am I"? Here am I. Amen. Here am I. The Lord will touch both of you. Amos and Amos. Just that. God want to bring you to a place of closer relationship in this time. Father, in the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. As they came here by divine appointment, I declare rescue for these. Whatever in their mind, whatever in their spirit, and whatever they want to accomplish. I'm declaring on this day, on the second day of October 2022, that your fire will touch down upon them both. I declare the anointing to bring them out supernaturally. I release fire from the pulpit to their very spaces, that the atmosphere is charged with the blood. And in the name of Jesus, I declare a victory over their lives, that they shall be strong and anchored in you. I cancel every plot and plan of the evil one to get them into a place where they will have divided loyalties. I decree now fire in the Holy Ghost. I declare fire in the Holy Ghost. Receive the fire of the Holy God. In the name of Jesus, I declare it right now. Right now, holy fire. Take the fire of God upon your life. Both of you. Yes, fire. Fire, fire for deliverance. Fire for wholeness. I can't. Everything that will hinder growth, everything that will hinder you from moving forward, you hold. I cancel it in the name of Jesus. I declare you shall serve in the joy of the Lord, that you shall walk in ministry, that you shall fulfill even your purpose and destiny. Every relationship that is not of God, I break it in the name of Jesus. And our young people shall serve the Lord in spirit and in truth. I break everything that comes to break you. Father, when their eyes may not see, I'm declaring that their eyes be open to see and hear. Break every contrary spirit. I find you in the name of Jesus. Watch God work. Watch the fire that is going to set ablaze upon her. And even as she will dance supernaturally. Even as she serves the Lord, it will be at a higher level as she trusts Him. So, Father, as you have said it, I send the fire upon her very feet. I declare it shall trample upon the works of the enemy. Holy fire, holy fire, holy fire. Holy fire. Serving with loyalty, his duties, a helper in the temple. And the light went out, the Bible is saying there, and they laid their head to sleep, and God began to call. But in the calling, the young man was not aware of the voice of God calling. If you are not aware this morning, I pray clarity that you will hear and know God's voice. It will fill you with him. And the Bible says, and the Lord called yet again in verse 6, Samuel, and Samuel arose and went to Eli and said, Here am I, for thou didst call me. And he answered, I call not my son, I don't know him. So this is the second time. The willingness of the servant to fulfill duty.
Amen.
Amen. Whatever hour of the night it was, the young man was getting up and going to the priest.
Amen.
Amen. As the priest's eyes were dim, I look at some people and they go to the different institution with their family, their granny, grandpa, parents, whatever it is. And they are not willing to hold their hand. They are not willing to assist them properly. But when, you know, at the institution there, at the counter, and thankfully the sign, they reach at the counter to help them sign. Especially the parents. I've seen it so many times.
Amen.
Other than that, you sit quite down there on the ground, it's quite there by herself. The paper fall, the little bag, you know, like a rock thing in bag, and it drop. And when it drop, they fight in to pick it up. And they stick on one hand, and they see they're twisting. But then I don't know what's in the document, so I don't offer to pick up anything. And just like that, they'll run and take it. Because I saw they keep it somewhere. And then they wouldn't even come and pick it up, but from the time we reached that part, a long time, yeah, we had to find what's on the ticket. Let us not be like that, amen?
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let us do things with a genuine heart. Even if it's your granny or your parents, and they may not have money to give you, do it out of love. Because we are commanded to honor our parents.
Amen.
Amen. Because one day, should the Lord tarry, you may get old, and whatever you sow, you shall reap.
Amen.
So, release mercy and love.
Amen.
And the Bible says, verse 7, Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord, neither was the word of the Lord yet revealed unto him. And the Lord called Samuel again the third time. And he arose and went to Eli and said, Here am I, for thou didst call me. And Eli perceived that the Lord had called the child. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that there, that spiritual perception, Eli realized now that the Lord was literally calling Samuel.
Amen.
To speak with Samuel. When you are lying down, begin to express your love and your connectivity with our Father, even in the night. That should he desire to speak some secret into your ear, your ears are being.
Amen.
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 Much is not available, I realize, but you can make yourself
available. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The best voice you will ever hear in your ear is the voice of the Father God who loves. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And the most thunderous voice you can hear also is the voice of God. Amen. Because when we are not doing it right, his voice is as the voice of the tongue. Amen.
Amen.
So we gotta love God.
Hallelujah.
It's just God's presence in his place. Sanctuary. May your people live to hear your voice. May your people hear your voice. because some of you are so roaming that you cannot find rest. He said, it's time to come home, sons and daughters. You that have been prodigals, come home. Come home, come home. Some in the church, but not in me, say the Lord. He said, come home. Come home, come home. For the time is at hand where you will see and you will hear many of you. But let my presence be your God and your guide. Let my anointing break the yokes that are heavy upon your life. Seek me while you will find me. I am the Lord that healed you.
Hallelujah.
I am the God of your salvation. Call upon me. Fear thou not. I will not hurt thee, but I will heal. I will bless thee. As I said in my word, I will take sickness from in the midst of you and also your loved one. As you all trust me, those that need a healing stand quickly, there is a grace in this house. There's a grace in the house at all times. Lift your hand quickly, and you receive right where you are.
Receive, some of you just want to feel the warmth of God. Yes, I command
that under check. Now, I declare normalcy of blood flow. Normalcy. Yes, receive. 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 Receive.
Healing, daughter.
receive healing. Healing, fresh rain, healing. Just fresh rain upon you, Lord. Healing. Of every area of your body, healing. You said this one arrested you, Lord. I feel so tired and I don't know why. I just want to rest. I just want to rest. I don't know what is happening, but I just want to rest. Relationship with you, son. He says, now is the time. He says, I'm about to open the heavens and give you better, great things. But you have petitioned. Oh, may my Satan be your eyes. You don't fuss, you just go with me. But the Lord said, this season I'm changing. Lord, let fire come. In the name of Jesus, take it. In the name of Jesus. Children, you have to allow them to be called up at times.
Amen.
You can pray and advise for 3 hours and you have to call them and call them. But they can't sit and teach for 1 hour because they have child. But God said, train up the child in the way he should do. Say, let's not kill the child.
Amen.
And bring the child and give him the word.
Amen.
So that the word. Stand up. Stand up. Stand up. I hear the Lord say, you're so distressed. Stand up. Stand up, my boy. Stand up. I hear the Lord say, you're so distressed. Father. You are so distressed that you share it with no one. And it's overwhelming you. You started having pains recently in your body. Hey, Kata, yeah, no way. Hey, Kata, Mama Shoto, I declare healing right now. I declare the stress that has come upon me will not cause any damage. I declare right now the healing power of the mighty. Lord, that whoever he needs to communicate with, where the stress has been overwhelming now, I declare he will be able to have clear lines of communication to reach those individuals. I declare fire to deliver him. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive in the name of Jesus. Jesus' mighty name.